Alright, hey guys, welcome back. Alright, so, this video is for cinematic animations inside of Unreal Engine. Now, it's actually pretty simple. First and foremost, I decided to make a new scene, put a little bit of greenery rain in here, and use some of the standard assets inside of Unreal Engine to make this scene, a little bit more interesting instead of just being a blank canvas. If you are wondering why, on the right-hand side, I have my normal viewport, but on the left-hand side, I have this thing, and it says Pilot Active Cinematic Actor. That is because, in Unreal Engine, you can actually split your scene view into two windows, and have one window display your normal viewport, the other one display a camera. The way you do that is you click on this little arrow here, and you go to where it says layout, and if you hover over it, you have one that says one pane or two pane. And what I do is I just have two panels or two planes, so I can separate it into two and more accurately decide what I want this to be. Once that's done, I click on perspective and just click cinematic camera, and your camera will be selected. If I wanted this to go to our top, to my top view, I can just click this, and now in my top view. But for this purposes, since we're doing a cinematic animation, I need to know where the camera is and what the camera looks like at all times. So I'm doing it this way. So I click this top, and then I go back to place cameras and go to the cinematic actor 1. The view distance is a little bit off, but I am not going to worry about that. This is just a quick video to show you how to use cinematic animations. There we go. Now it's better. Alright, cool. So to get started, I already made a level sequences folder. So I'm going to go into this folder. I'm going to right click and I'm going to go to animation. Then I'm going to go to level sequence. Now level sequence should be familiar from earlier in this course when we decided to make a elevator and make boxes and whatnot move. It's the same concept, but in this case, we're going to do something a little bit different to get these animations to work. So I'm going to name this, walk, intro, park. Okay, no, I guess I'm not naming it. And we'll decide to save while I was naming stuff. Intro, park, anim. So I named this intro, park, anim. I'm going to go into this. And now my sequencer will appear. Now before when we did this, what we did was we clicked the add button and we did actor to sequence. This time we're going to do something a little bit differently. We're not going to do it this way. We are actually going to go to camera cut track. And we'll click on this. And we will get, we'll be brought with this camera cuts menu. Now the reason we're doing camera cuts and not the actor sequencer method that we did before is the actor sequencer is really great for animations that happen in the scene when you're playing a game. But in order for us to actually do camera cuts, we actually need to use this camera cut feature inside of the level sequencer to get the most accurate results. So the first thing I'm going to do is I see camera cuts. I'm going to click this camera button right here. And I'm going to click on cinematic camera. And right now, we have the cinematic camera in here. And we also have this plus under cinematic camera actor. I'm going to add a track, and I'm going to add a transform track. So I can actually animate the transform or the movement of this object. So, first thing I'm going to do, like we did before when we were doing timeline animations, is I'm going to set the first keyframe. Now, I want this animation to happen over the span of about, let's say 3 seconds. So, in Unreal right now, this Unreal is set to 30 frames per second. So, I'm going to go to the 90 frame mark by dragging along until I see 90. And always make sure you drag along the timeline before you do any movement of any animation. So, I'm dragging along the timeline to 90. And then, I'm going to go back into Unreal. And I'm going to animate this camera. And like so. And now, even though it's moving a lot, Unreal is only going to pay attention to the point where I actually end that, and it's going to smooth out any of this jittery movement that I have going on right here. So I want to focus in right here. I think this is a pretty good shot. It might animate weird, but eh, don't really care. So I'm going to go here. And I'm going to go to keyframe. And now let's see if this animated properly. It should have, but oh, we got to check to make sure. If I minimize this, I can see that it's animating properly and it's going right to where I want it to be. Cool. Now, from there, we're going to save this. And let's see if we can add another camera for the actor. Does not seem like we can do that. So we are just going to save this. And we are going to minimize this window. Now, assuming that that has been set up, what we now need to do is we need to, I'm going to bring this layout back to 1 because I'm tired of looking at everything this way. The actor camera right now is on perspective, which is exactly what I want. And I'm just going to put this right here just so I can see what's going on. Now that we've done this, I want to make it so that, where's my player start? Player start is below the ground. Let's make it above the ground so I can actually use it. So what I'm going to do is I am going to go to blueprints and open a level blueprint. In this level blueprint, I am going to delete this nonsense because I don't need it. That was not delete. This is delete. So I want to make it so that when I step, I'll have my player start maybe around here somewhere. And right now it says bad size, which means just colliding with something. I'm just going to move it up so it's not colliding anymore. And I'm going to make the arrow point in this direction so the actor is facing towards the table and chair. So, what I want to do is I want to make a trigger box. A box trigger. Right here. And I want to make it so that when the actor touches this box trigger, it will trigger the animation that we just created to play. So, put it in, I size the bounding box for this box trigger up as much as I want to. So now I am going to go into level blueprint, and I'm going to right click, and I'm going to do an on actor begin overlap. Now, when an actor touches this trigger box, the first thing I want to do is I want to type in cinematic mode, and make sure context sensitive is checked on. Cinematic mode, and first thing you want to do is you want to turn on cinematic mode. When cinematic mode is on, that means that all of this stuff here will begin to activate. So if you want it to affect the hide the player, you can check that on so that when you go into cinematic mode, the player is hidden, you don't see it, and you only see the camera. You want it to affect the HUD, you want it to affect movement and turning. I'm actually going to check these on as well, just because I don't like movement when animations are playing. From then, what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually do something similar to what we did before, where we create a sequence, a reference to the sequence. So I'm going to go to, let's just type in sequence. That's not what I wanted. Create level sequence player. There we go. From here, I will select the level sequence, and I want intro pack animation. I meant this to be park, but whatever. Return value, I want to play this animation. And then, after all that's said and done, what I want to do is I want it to end the animation. Or I want to end the animation, and the animation ends in about 3 seconds, so I'm actually going to set delay. Actually, no. I'm going to end the animation. The animation ends, and I'm going to go to cinematic mode. I want to set the cinematic mode again. Now, the reason why I'm setting the cinematic mode 2 times is because when you first touch the trigger box, when it goes into this first set cinematic mode it will be set to on. When cinematic mode is set to on, it will hide all of this stuff. But after the cinematic ends, you want cinematic mode to be checked off. Checked off or set to false, and you also want to be able to actually enable all this movement and turning and everything else. So now that's it, I'm going to compile and we are going to hope it works. So I'm going to press play and let's see what happens. Oh, it played the animation. Just like that. Now, if I go into it again, it'll play the animation again. And then it'll go away and you can move again. Now, you'll notice a couple issues. The first issue being, when the cinematic happens, you can actually still move your player. Now, I don't know about you, but I like my games where when a cinematic happens, I don't want to accidentally press forward on my keyboard or analog stick and wonder how my character got from point A to point B and is now fighting a dragon. So, what we're going to do is we're going to end this. We know this first part is working. What we do next is we're going to adjust this a little bit. So the first thing is, I noticed two problems with the animation. One problem, I said, the other problem was, every time I entered that trigger, kept going, leaving and entering that trigger box, it would keep trying to play that animation. I don't want that. I only want my animation to play once when I touch that trigger box. So the correction I'm going to do is I'm going to drag off of this one pin, this white pin here, and I'm going to type in do once. So it does this animation once. From there, I am going to, when I compile it and press play, I will notice that when I press play and go into it, if I try and go back into this trigger box, it doesn't work. That's because we told Unreal I only want to play this animation once before I do anything else. That's done. Now, the next thing we need to do, we need to adjust the fact that you can move and do a lot of other stuff that you really should not be able to do when cinematics happen. So let's first go, since that happened under the first cinematic node, we'll go to this first node and see what is going on. Now, let's see, we're taking a look at this. It says, let me uncheck this and this. Okay. So let me just compile this first and see what this does. If it does what I think it'll do. Yep, it does. Alright, so I actually had it right before, but I realized what I did was, in here, when you set the cinematic mode, you turn this on and you want to hide the player, you want to affect the heads-up display, affect the movement, and affect the turning. What this essentially does is, this one makes it so you can't move. This makes it so you can't turn. This hides the player and this enters cinematic mode. In fact, I don't really need to hide the player, but I'll just turn it back on just because. Actually, no, I'll leave it like that. Now, the reason why I was still able to move once the cinematic was over is because when I set the cinematic mode at the end after the play, when you set it, the cinematic mode to be off, I had all this other stuff checked on, like hide player and all this other stuff. Especially affect movement and affect turning. When cinematic mode is off and you have affect movement, that means that you can move. When it's on and you have affect movement checked on, that means that it can't move. So, what I did was I just turned this stuff off. And I play the animation. And I can't move when the animation starts. But with that, I also encounter another problem. I can't move at all. I can jump. I can possibly hop over a rolling barrel that's coming straight at me, but I can't do much else. So what I'm going to do is I am going to actually, on this play note, I'm going to set a delay. Because we do need the effect movement and turning to be checked on. I'm going to set a delay. After it plays, I'm going to wait till the end of this animation before I start triggering this set cinematic mode to be on. Well, off. And now affect those two things. Compile it. Press play. And when cinematic mode comes on, it plays the animation. It goes away. I can move again. And I can jump. And these benches are very small. Or I'm very big. One or the other. Anyway, hope this video was very helpful for you, and I look forward to seeing some awesome cinematic animations from you. Alright guys, see you later. Bye.